We should have sound now. That is the online people, no sound. Yep, we should have it now. I turned on my microphone. Okay, yes, okay, we're online. Well, Peace Lutheran had a fantastic day yesterday with our bazaar. And I truly have come to appreciate the labor of love that goes on to pull off what the ladies and then some of the men in the kitchen help do. And they start planning months out, save things throughout the year. And it's just wonderful to, again, to be able to open up our church doors and for people to come in and just experience the abundance of what was out in our fellowship hall yesterday. So I suggest we give all of these bizarre ladies just a big round of applause. Well done. Budget meeting will happen today immediately following this service. Looking for my council president? Nope. There he is. Okay. Terry, do you want to have the meeting here in the sanctuary, or should we move to the fellowship hall? Oh, and when are we doing the raffles, Jan?
5 items and tickets for the drawing and also for the time. So we'll have the opportunity and then we'll move the drawing right after fellowship.
Okay, so what I suggest we do then is at the end of today's worship service, we'll take a break, go out to the fellowship hall, look at stuff, and then we'll shortly convene the annual budget meeting after that. Yeah, okay. Wonderful. Okay. And it was kind of cool. You can't see this, but the online community sent the little clapping hands. So you were clapped for virtually. That's pretty cool. That's what I love about this hybrid. And with that, I invite you to prepare our hearts and minds for worship with the confession and forgiveness as found in our bulletin. Almighty God, you warn us to read the signs for the coming of your glory. In the sun, the moon, the stars, the roaring of the seas and the waves, the distress among the nations. We have seen it all before. Nothing seems to change. Forgive our lapse of focus, our sense that nothing ever really changes. Teach us to wait with patience, that we may be ready. Amen. We belong to our Lord Jesus Christ. Believe the promise of your baptism. In Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. Amen. I invite you to pray the prayer of the day with me. O God, the protector of all who trust in you, without you nothing is strong, nothing is holy. Embrace us with your mercy, that with you as our ruler and guide, we may live through what is temporary, without losing what is eternal. Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Psalm 98. O sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have gained him victory. The Lord has made known his victory. He has revealed his vindication in the sight of the nations. He has remembered his steadfast love and faithfulness to the house of Israel. All the ends of the earth seeing the victory of our God. Let the sea roar and all that fills it, the world and those who live in it. Let the floods clap their hands. Let the hills sing together for joy at the presence of the Lord, for he is coming to judge the earth. He will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with equity. Our gospel text today is from the 21st chapter of Luke, towards the end of Luke's gospel. And to put this in context, Jesus, where we are in the gospel story of Luke, is we're essentially in Holy Week. Palm Sunday has happened, and now Jesus is spending his nights sleeping out in the Mount of Olives. And then he comes into the day, and he's been teaching every single day in the temple. So where we are picking up today is Jesus is in the temple, and he is teaching. And the next day will be the preparation for Passover. The Holy Gospel according to Luke, the 21st chapter. The destruction of the temple foretold. When some were speaking about the temple, how it was adorned with beautiful stones and gifts dedicated to God, Jesus said, "As for these things that you see, the days will come when not one stone will be left upon another. All will be thrown down." They asked him, "Teacher, when will this be, and what will be the sign that this is about to take place?" And Jesus said, "Be aware that you are not led astray, for many will come in my name and say, 'I am he,' and 'the time is near.' Do not go after them. When you hear of wars and insurrections, do not be terrified, for these things must take place first, but the end will not follow immediately." Then Jesus said to them, "Nation will rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom. There will be great earthquakes, and in various places, famines and plagues. And there will be dreadful portents and great signs from heaven. But before all this occurs, they will arrest you and persecute you. They will hand you over to synagogues and prisons, and you will be brought before kings and governors because of my name. This will give you an opportunity to testify. So make up your minds not to prepare your defense in advance, for I will give you words and wisdom that none of your opponents will be able to withstand or contradict. You will be betrayed even by parents and brothers, by relatives and friends, and they will put some of you to death. You will be hated by all because of my name. But not a hair on your head will perish. By your endurance, you will gain your souls." The Gospel of our Lord. Grace and peace to you from Jesus Christ, God's only Son. Amen. The day will come when not one stone will be left upon another. All will be thrown down. Jesus is telling them that the temple, the most holy place, and where God meets God's people, is going to be destroyed. And it was. The temple in the year 70 was destroyed by the Romans, and there was not one stone left after all had burned. Scary stuff, a scary passage. Nation against nation, great earthquakes, plagues. Does it kind of sound like our time? Right now? But Jesus said this: "Do not be terrified. I will give you words and wisdom. By your endurance, you will gain your souls." Now, I'm inviting you to do this for me right now. I want you to think back to March 2020. Think back to, as the summer played out, George Floyd, riots in Minneapolis. For us, the fall, when the pandemic came north and our hospitals, St. Luke, St. Mary's, started filling up. And what I want you to think about right now, and I want you to close your eyes, and for those of you who were online with Facebook Live here, I want you to place yourself wherever you were and were watching, participating in worship on Facebook Live. Think back to one of those times. Now close your eyes and listen to my voice. Oh God, the protector of all who trust in you. Without you, nothing is strong, nothing is holy. Embrace us with your mercy, that with you as our ruler and guide, we may live through what is temporary, without losing what is eternal, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Have you heard this prayer before? Have you heard this prayer before? Now what I'm going to ask you to do is take out your hymnals. And I want invite you to open up your hymnals to the very beginning of the hymnal, to page 15, way, way in the front. Actually, page 18. We're way in front of the hymnal. Page 18. And then I want you to take your fingers and open it then, holding place for page 18, then to page 51. So what you are looking at between pages 18 and 51 is every prayer of the day that starts our worship service. And all of these prayers are given to us. So, you know, we talk about the lectionary, year A, B, and C. We're in year C. And there you look for dates. Well, the fourth, we're two Sundays from now, we'll start Advent. Flip a few pages. There you see we're in the season of Christmas. And so say on Christmas Day, those are the prayers given to us that we would pray on Christmas Day. And indeed, for every Sunday, the prayer of the day is given to us. And then if you want to just go straight to page 51, there you see for the Sunday between November 13th and 19th, we're in year C. And I also printed that out for you, today's prayer, on the front of your bulletin cover. And there you see it circled. Have you heard this prayer before? We started this prayer on Palm Sunday, 2020. I thumbed through all of these prayers. This was the third Sunday when our country shut down on March 22nd, our first Sunday in exile. And I read through all of these prayers, trying to find a prayer that I thought could encompass all what we were feeling here at the start of the pandemic. And I came across today's prayer. We did that prayer on Palm Sunday. I can't make this up. We said this prayer until Pentecost Sunday, 2021, and that was the first Sunday that we gathered again when it was safe to do so again. I never changed the prayer of the day. And even as I would be broadcasting the services, often alone here, I made up a bulletin for every Sunday because I needed to follow the order of worship. And if you were to look in every one of these bulletins, you would find this prayer we did today. I didn't start out Palm Sunday saying, oh gosh, I've selected this prayer for today, and now I'm just going to say this prayer, you know, for the next few Sundays. I didn't start that way. But as the pandemic wore on, what I was given was that you guys would hear my voice every Sunday with this prayer of, we will live through what is temporary without losing what is eternal. I wanted that to be like that earworm, and that you would hear my voice every Sunday saying, without God, nothing is holy. Without God, nothing is strong. Embrace us with your mercy, that we can live through what is temporary. I had no idea until this week, actually, and I was going to type in for this week the prayer of the day, and lo and behold, there it was. So we haven't said this prayer since May of 2021, but it was the assigned prayer for today. And truth be told, on that Palm Sunday of 2020, you know, off to the side there, you see the assigned lessons for the day. I never looked at what the lessons were. I just fell in love with this prayer. And if I had looked at that prayer that day, and then, I mean, the lessons that went with it, it would have been the destruction of the temple. And doesn't that feel like we've just been through the whole year, we're apart from one another, and we could not gather together as a community? It did feel like our temple, in many ways, was torn down. Do not be terrified. We were given words and wisdom, and we have persevered with endurance to this day. We have lived through what is temporary without losing what is eternal. Thanks be to God. Amen. I invite you to sing our hymn of the day. Upbeat song, Listen, God is Calling. Again, without God, nothing is strong, nothing is holy. I invite you to stand and sing hymn 513. Lenny's not sure we can pull this one off. It's always twice. So the refrain is always sung twice. And we have no leader. We are all leaders today. We're all going to sing our little hearts out. Listen, God is calling.
With the listen God is calling, the prayer response, I will say, help us to be faithful, and I invite you to respond with standing steadfast. Help us to be faithful, standing steadfast. Listen, listen, God is calling through the word inviting. Renewing God. As the northern hemisphere prepares for winter, make us mindful of the ordered beauty of your creation. Teach us to treasure cycles of rest and new life. Help us care for what you have made. Help us to be faithful, standing steadfast. Loving God, accompany all who make sacrifice for the sake of others. Safeguard first responders and active duty military personnel. Grant peace to veterans and heal any wounds in body, mind, or spirit. Help us to be faithful, standing steadfast. Healing God, your people continue to cry out to you. Sustain doctors, nurses, and hospital personnel and chaplains in their tireless work. Uphold mental health professionals and those in their care. May the sun of righteousness rise on all who are sick. Help us to be faithful, standing steadfast. Uniting God, unite this assembly. Unite us with you in our shared mission and ministry for the sake of the gospel. For without you, nothing is strong and nothing is holy. Highlight ways we can better work together and give us patience to work through disagreement. Help us to be faithful, standing steadfast. Consoling God, abide with all. Abide with all who grieve for loved ones who have died. By your endurance, sustain them. Comfort us with the promise of resurrection and new life with you. Help us to be faithful, standing steadfast. Accept these prayers, gracious God, and those known only to you through Jesus Christ our Lord. Help us to be faithful, standing steadfast, walking in your precepts, led by your word. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Peace of the Lord be with you. I invite you to share. Be well in Christ. Out of exile into the future. We bless you, O God. We give you thanks for your dear Son and the heart of human life, near to those who suffer. Beside the sinner, among the poor with us now, we thank you, O God. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us again the prayer. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Whenever we eat this bread, we share the body of Christ. Taste and see that the Lord is good. You may be seated. And for our communion today, after we sing Lamb of God, Lenny will continue on and play "Christ Be Our Light," hymn number 715.
Thank you. body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ keep you in endurance and keep you in his mercy and grace. Amen. Receive the benediction. So now we leave this space of worship. And still, while so much of the road ahead is uncertain, we know some things that are solid and sure as the ground beneath our feet and the sky above our heads. Christ risen will bring life from death. Be well in Christ. Christ is with you.
Thanks be to God.
And I invite you to stand and sing soon and very soon. In 439.
Serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And we.